Hey guys, welcome to another very exciting tutorial of creation process. In this video, we're learning how to create a professional logo. So, we'll take an ellipse tool. Draw one more ellipse tool, insert it, give some depth. Now select both the circle and go to Pathfinder and subtract. Now, what we need to do is we need a rectangle and give some thickness, this much. Now adjust it in the center of the circle. See that the points are intersecting over each other. Now when you've done that, duplicate it, Control C and Control F to paste it on the front. Go to rotate tool, double click on it. Okay, angle, set angle 30 and copy. Again go, set angle 30, copy. Do this for a few more times the same way. Copy and paste. When you have done this, just select all of them and deselect the circle and go to Pathfinder and combine it. Now when you combine that, select the circle and this shape which you have made recently and subtract it from there. And once you have done that, you got a cool design. Now what we need to do is we need to adjust the color. First, before that, I'll ungroup this up, divide it and ungroup it up. Now everything will be separate. So I need this. I'm making this in one group, which I'm selecting and keeping one separate. So I select this and group it. So this is one group and this is singular. Now select this one and apply some gradient. Play with the gradients. So let's apply some gradient. And this is linear, I think. So go to gradient and make it radial. And in the center, just give some gradient color, some shades. Here give some brightness and here some dark. Little bit of darkness here, like this, or maybe a little more. This much. Once you get this, or you can change, even give different colors. For example, if you want to give red, orange, blue, whichever color you choose, it's your wish. I think I should take gray color. Once you have done that, select this one. Control Z, sorry. Yep. Select this one and apply different color or gradient. So go here and let's choose blue and go to blue and just give it a little more darker and make this light blue. Go here and make it lighter. Now apply the gradient. So once you have done that, select this and group it, Control J. Before that, just make some correction to the gradient. I think it's a little bit of dullness is there, so select it, do the same stuff until you feel it right, make it more dark, same way. Okay, once you are happy with that, select this, Control G, go to Windows and 3D, sorry, Effect, 3D, Extrude and Bevel. You can preview it over here. It's a very important part. It's a very 3D extrude and bevel option is very good for your designs if you want it in a 3D structure. So you can see that when I preview it, you can see it's in 3D form. You can control the angle here, in which angle you want to rotate. I'll just the thickness is very high, so I'll reduce it here. You get the thickness, so reduce it to 3. Okay, once you have done that, you can even change the designs, whether you want a classic look. See, you can see there's a change, whether you want a zaggy look, you'll see there's a zaggy look. So I need right now, I need a none, that is a plain surface. And yeah, you can change the angle here. And the important part of this is that what I'm going to use is the perspective. Perspective plays an important role. So here you can see it's like flat. So I'll increase the perspective angle. you can see it's going in the deeper there. This portion is nearer to us and this portion is far. If you increase it more, you can see that will go more further. Yeah, so I don't need that much. I'll need this. That's my 27. I think 127 is good. And now just adjust the angles in which angle you want to rotate it. Okay, once you get that, you can even play with it here. Surface, which what in which style you want. You want it in wireframe. You can see it. It turns into wireframe, or maybe non-shady, or diffuse, and plastic shade. So I'll take a plastic shading, and click OK. So your design is almost ready. You get a different style using the perspective tool and 3D option. Now just go to object and expand appearance. It will convert this into object form. Now this is the design. Now we'll just add some text. For example, ordinary, ordinary, and just turn this to, that's a blue, dark blue, and just scale this up. Okay, give this one with a big capital O, or maybe simple O, ordinary, and just turn, I'll just give some gray color to this. It's very harsh color. And if you want to give some shadow effect, you can go to the ellipse tool, create a small, this one, make it black effect, blur, Gaussian blur, preview it, and click OK, and just put it below it, and reduce its opacity. Go here, transparency, and reduce opacity to 60%, and your ordinary logo. So this is how you can create a cool professional logo. I have given ordinary name, just I thought of this word. So hope you enjoy the tutorial. Check out my next tutorial. Thank you.